Hi everyone, I'm fine. Hope you are also fine. So in today's rapid revision, we will see five more current affairs, okay, which will be easy for you to recollect and revise during this pandemic time. Hope so. Let's go. The first one, New Space India Limited, NSIL. It is a new company that is wholly owned Government of India undertaking or Central Public Center. Public sector enterprise company established under Department of Space. Department of Space comes under the administrative control of Prime Minister's office. We know space atomic energy comes under Prime Minister's office control. Okay, so this is to commercially exploit the research and development work of ISRO to bring more innovative products in future. Okay. So, from the supply-driven model to demand-driven model, they are shifting. Sisseri River Bridge, always the river bridge and all, they will be asking in UPSC prelims, like Dola Sadia Bridge asked earlier. So, Sisseri is a tributary of Brahmaputra River. It comes under the Ministry of Defense. It is this Sisseri River Bridge is located at Lower Dibong Valley in Arunachal Pradesh. Dibong is also a tributary of River Brahmaputra. It is a 200 meter long bridge which is connecting Jonai Pasikat and Ranagat Drawing Road. It provides better connectivity between these two valleys, Siang and Dibong Valley, Siang district and Dibong Valley. So it comes under the project Brahman. It comes under a project Brahmank of Border Roads Organization. So project Brahmank is one of the four projects under Border Roads Organization. It also comes under Border Area Development Program, which is doing construction of road infrastructure in the north and northeastern states, especially in the remote areas of north and northeastern states. BRO, Border Roads Organization, is established in 1982. It comes under Ministry of Defense since 2015. Border Area Development Program is a centrally sponsored scheme, means central government will be contributing some percentage and state government or union territories will be contributing certain percentage. So they are administered under the Department of Border Management, which comes under Ministry of Home Affairs. Daslik exercise 2019. So Daslik means friendship in Uzbek. It comes under Ministry of Defense. Always the military exercises will be coming under Ministry of Defense only. It is the first ever Indo-Uzbekistan joint field training exercise. So there is more chance of asking in prelims. So it is a defense collaboration between India and Uzbekistan. For the first time, it was held at Chirchik training area in Tashkent, which is the capital of Uzbekistan. So its scope is to counter the insurgency and also counter terrorism between the both the countries. Pashmina shawls, it is a GI tagged product. And it recently received a BIS, Bureau of Indian Standards Certification. BIS is a national standard body which is created under Bureau of Indian Standards Act 2016, which is amended. Okay. So, Pashmina shawls got BIS certification. No? So, it comes under Ministry of Textiles. Why it was given? BIS certification means to protect the interest of the local artisans for their creativity and the nomads who are the producers of Pashmina raw materials, which was got from the goat. And also there were adulteration in Pashmina raw material, and those products are also circulating. So to curb this also and to assure the purity of Pashmina for the customers, because quality is must. Okay, we are also exporting these wool to other countries. So Ladakh Union Territory produces 50 million tons of finest grade of Pashmina because its fiber thickness is about 12 to 15 microns in fiber thickness, and it is the hand spun and first ever woven in Kashmir region. So Pashmina shawls also can be asked. See here how beautiful the Chantanki or Chankra or Pashmina goat in Ladakh region, especially it will be roaming around Leh district. We will see about Chantanki or Pashmina goat. Okay, it is a special breed of goat and it is indigenous. We can see this Pashmina goat only in Ladakh region. It always confines to the high altitude region only. Okay, it is raised especially for the For its 12 to 15 micron thickness Kashmiri wool, generally it is domesticated and it is reared by nomadic communities who will roam from one place to another, especially by Changpong communities in the Changtung region of Ladakh Union Territory. So Kashmiri wool or Pashmina wool has revitalized the economy of Changtung, Leh and Ladakh region in Ladakh Union Territory. This time they may ask this Changtangi Pashmina goat or Pashmani shawls because of the abrogation of Article 370. And it is reared by Karnak nomads, one of the four major Changpa tribes. So that's all for today. Keep revising, keep preparing. Thank you for watching. Subscribe to App IAS channel. Stay positive, stay healthy, keep smiling, be happy.